that. You know, when you think about Christmas in Canada, traditionally it's snow. I mean, it's a good time if there's snow and it's cold and slush and your feet are always wet and you got a little bit of a chill on. How'd you like to spend 10 days in bright, intense sunshine and temperatures that average around 30 degrees in January? You could, as MuchMusic, Varag Airlines, and Farewell Tours could send you down to Rio de Janeiro for 12 days in January for the Rock in Rio Festival. Here's how you can get in on it. All you have to do is send us, in an envelope, your name, address, telephone number, age, and three bands that are going to be performing at the Rock in Rio Festival. Along with it, send the cap liners of two bottles of Coca-Cola or a hand-drawn reasonable facsimile. And send it in to Rock in Rio, care of MuchMusic, 99 Queen Street East, Toronto, Ontario, M5C2M1. That's Rock and Rio, care of Munch Music, 99 Queen Street East, Toronto, Ontario, M5C2M1. We're going to be making the draw for the Rock and Rio prize this coming Sunday, so make sure that you get your entries in soon. You and a friend could be spending 12 beautiful days in Rio de Janeiro from January the 10th to the 22nd and taking in the largest rock festival in history. Get your entries in soon. We have a super session with Diana Ross coming up right after this.
Hello, my name's Cy Conan from The Fix, and I'd just like to point out to you that somebody gave us the intelligence to invent these things, and it's nice to see them being used to communicate with you all. So, coast to coast, you're watching MuchMusic.
Time for our daily super session on MuchMusic, and in the spotlight today we have Diana Ross. What can you say about this lady except that she has survived 20 years in a business that usually chews people up in a couple of years and spits them out the other side? She turned 40 in March of this year, and she doesn't look a day over 30. It looks like she hasn't aged since 1966. I remember seeing her in Mahogany. I think it was 1973, the movie that she starred in. And she looks exactly the same now as she did back then. It's almost like she is frozen in time. One thing that Diana Ross has done over the last 2 years is some darn good videos. Swept Away, which is the new one, also the one with Julio Iglesias. I think one of the nicest videos that I have seen Diana Ross do is one that she did with superstar director Bob Giraldi, which is Pieces of Ice. Diana Ross reacts to video. Is it going to be a savior for the music industry?
I think it's a wonderful idea to see picture with song, and it possibly will. It's a great idea, a great vehicle for record sales and for the kids, you know. What I like about having a song without video is that people are able to use their imagination. It's like they can create what they think the story's about, and they will begin to have a personal identity with it. Sometimes the video will give you an image and you think that that's what the song's about. Now, our song, Pieces of Ice, is a very abstract song, and we're doing the kind of video is almost Fellini-ish in movie kind of terms, where it has really no meaning. It means nothing, but it's interesting and fun. But I always like people to go inside themselves and have their own experience in when I do a song. So I don't know. I think I do think it is something that is the future.